Yes.
So fear goes down your spine.
Yeah.
What do you want to do?
I want to look for something sharp and pointed.
Like I said, like he's got his dagger.
Bye.
He's got a dagger?
Yeah, so you're going to go this time?
Yeah.
Now you're gone?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm a human being.
Did you say being?
Now he's a human going.
Yeah, I'm gonna go for his dagger.
Okay. Go for it.
70.
You miss?
70. No.
So when you do, he realizes what you do, you're doing, and he kind of backs up a little bit, and he goes like this.
Uh-huh.
It's like giving you this blurger. Like he's not.
Right, right.
And
it's halt.
He kind of backs up a little bit. And
I would start to pull my sword, probably.
He goes, I think she doesn't understand what we're saying. Blurga.
Okay, but this is what I was worried about.
I know. You stay here with her. I'll go see if I can get Inga, or maybe my twit son will know how to speak to her.
Okay.
I'll be back.
Okay.
Is there anybody else in the village that knows whatever she's, this Murph thing she keeps saying?
I don't know. I have no idea what she's speaking.
Murph.
The only one I know who knows the strange languages is your son.
Well, what about the Scald?
He might. I guess it's possible.
Go get him.
Are you going to stay with her?
I'll go get him. Stay here. I don't want her freaking out. Just don't stab her.
I won't stab her.
I know you like stabbing people.
only for glory. After this, what glory would I get out of that? She's not a worthy foe.
I'm just making sure. All right, so you leave. Okay. So you're knee-deep in bear.
Why wouldn't you be?
Blood all over the place, cutting things up, having fun.
Yep. He's not throwing the intestines. That's a good part.
That's a good, no. He's got goat head in his come on.
I have some standards.
Sorry, he's wearing the intestines. Nice scarf.
And you take him, right? So she comes back probably, the Jarl comes back 10 minutes later, right? Because I forgot. The Jarl comes back, brings him,
Broggy.
Okay.
And he's covered in blood.
Oh, great.
Now, do you know any Gaelic? You probably know broken would be my guess.
Yeah, what I wrote on here based on what we talked about was Old English. But I don't know if...
You might know some Old English.
I would know Old English.
Yeah, yeah. So you speak in Old English to her. The Jarl says, tell her that she's safe, that we're not going to do anything.
Peace, where everything will be fine. We won't hurt you.
The man covered in blood says.
Right, right, right. Oh.
Am I rolling for this about how well I...
Yeah.
Would you know what she is? That she's a nun?
What she is? Are you a poodle?
I am. Secrets!
Secrets
coming out!
Bear!
Use your investigation.
Are you a swarm of bees?
Are you a swarm of bees?
Wearing a coat.
Not even close. That missed by a lot.
We'll kill you. Lots. Dead.
dead.
Well, he says the way... You say the proper words.
He's scary.
He's scary.
I hold up my crucifix, and I command Satan to be gone.
You know that this is a symbol of their god, and they only have one of those, which is kind of odd. God.
Jarl, this that is the symbol of their one god. You know, these people have just the one. They're so impoverished.
Where is this woman from?
From the Southlands, it looks like. Oh. Perhaps she might be one of the brides of their god.
How did she get all the way over here?
Blurg, 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 blurg. Yes.
How did you get here?
Do I understand that?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's all
English. When I speak to you,
I'm gonna speak gotcha.
Yeah.
Just like on Vikings.
Yes.
Thanks. I haven't watched Vikings either, so.
I haven't either. I just know that's a thing that sometimes happens.
You hear it.
It's a fun show.
It's a good show.
Yeah, I hear it. Anyway, go ahead.
Okay, so you say, how did I get here? I'm like, I don't know where here is. But I was taken from my nunnery by a pack of demons over the ocean to the gates of hell. And I clearly arrived there in hell. Look at you. These are what demons look like.
She was taken by monsters from her bride house.
What?
Bride house?
It's where they live. These ones live.
She's already married?
You are married?
Of course.
Yes.
Well, she says. That's too bad.
To my Lord and Savior.
To their God.
Wait a minute. That doesn't make any sense.
She's married to a God?
Just the one. But he has no power.
Oh.
But he's got lots of wives.
Many.
He's a polygamist.
There's whole houses filled with them.
Okay.
Their God's got guys.
He likes
no power, but man.
He typically likes the old ones.
Well, not back then. They were younger back then. Now all the nuns are old because no one's joining.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Back then they were all different ages.
All right.
Anyway, go ahead.
Yes, he has many, many wives, but cannot defend them. He has no men to protect them.
Well, then he needs a husband that maybe not the god, but that can defend him. Her.
Even Jarls are interested.
Anyway, tell
in
her
one
that she's
guy.
Safe. She's safe. We're going to get her some clothes that aren't messed up, and we're going to leave her here with Brenna.
Birna.
Birna. Hey, I was close there. Birna. That's good for me.
Yeah. The Jarl blood drinker will protect you, and he wishes you to wear better raiment.
This all sounds terrible. Everything you say sounds terrible.
You do not. You do not wish to be safe. You
Is
will be safe.
This hell, and how did I get here? I'm a good person.
This isn't hell. This is Scotland Yard.
She thinks this is the underworld.
No, for
the dishonorable.
What? No.
She thinks this is hell.
Oh, that's hell.
No. This is not hell. This is Stalingrad.
Stalingrad
doesn't exist yet.
This is Stavanger, the Northlands.
Even worse, Viking scum. Thieves.
We're not Viking right now.
Oh,
are
you're not?
Viking?
Are you? Not?
We're not Viking right now.
No. Viking is when you're actually going out and
okay.
attacking.
Norse scum. Is that better?
We're not. Okay.
Well,
actually. But technically proto-Norse by the fair.
We were Norse before it was cool.
Yeah.
So.
Before you Norsed. I'm sorry. Apologize.
I need water.
Okay.
I'm thirsty. And I need something to eat that isn't a rancid goat head.
Would you say that?
I just sense that that's something you'd kind of people would eat.
Would you say that you're cold?
I'm cold, wet.
Are you wet?
And
are
I'm you suffering.
Are you hysterical? Are you cold, wet, and hysterical?
No, I'm not.
Okay.
Cold, wet, and hysterical.
It's from the producers. Anyway.
Yeah.
She is thirsty. She hates our people. And she would like something to eat, but not something good like goat head.
Information in order of importance.
Okay. So there's still a chance. All right, I'll get her some water. We're going to leave her and get her dressed in some clothes that she won't die of cold from. And we'll figure this out later. Do you know where my stepson is?
I'll find him, Jarl.
I'll go with you. You stay here.
You're adopted.
Well, I'll take her to get some clothes, I guess.
Okay, so real quick, before I forget.
The dead one?
Braggy, you get one more point.
Two.
One more push?
One more hit point.
Oh, thank you.
I tried to phonetically spell that one out for you.
B-rat. B-rat? B-rat?
B-art.
B-art?
Thank you, B-art.
Skular.
Skular.
B-art Skular.
B-art Skular.
Yep.
That makes sense.
You know what happens is I look at them and I freak myself out before I say them even, and then I say them wrong. That's that's what happens.
I think that's it's total be how we anxiety.
No. It's totally
Yarskalar. Yarskalar.
And then do we want to leave that second one for a little later, or do we want to? Not the third one down. Do we want to leave that for a little later when he takes a? How many points did he? Did he pay for him to get, like the after that point that we just gave him back? Does that bring him all the way up?
Yeah.
Okay.
No. He's still not up with that 1 point.
Okay.
I am back to 10. I'm at 10 now with that point you just gave me.
Okay, and so he's got how many more points do you need?
12.
Did,
so 2 more.
So did he pay for 2 points or more than 2 points?
He paid for more than 2 points.
So he'll have bonus points then. We'll just add the like temporary points for however many he paid for. Would that work?
Sure.
Okay. So Barbor Mark, which is B-O-B-O-R-M-A-R-K.
Barbor Mark.
Rear ears.
Or Barbaron.
Barbor Mark gives you back all of your hit points plus a couple. I don't know how many bonus hit points.
Okay.
Killing the bear really gave you a feeling of
the strength of the bear.
Okay.
Eat its head.
Oh, I will.
Later.
But not right now.
When it's ripe.
In 6 days.
It needs to ripen.
So.
It's not ready.
You guys are in Inga's hut, and she's got Gura on the bed, and her arms kind of leaning off. She goes, "This is really bad. If we don't cut this off and stop the bleeding, she's gonna die. So you need to watch very closely."
Okay.
I want you to hold the arm as still as you can.
Okay.
It takes a delicate touch.
You know I have shaky hands.
Hold it the best you can. You gotta learn how to do this. If you're gonna be the healer, you can't.
Okay.
You can't screw this up. Give me a medicine roll.
Yes.
Nice. Six. So all of a sudden, this Zen moment comes over, which you have no idea what a Zen moment is, but that's what it is. And you're able to hold her hand, and it's perfectly still. And Helga takes up her blade. And goes, "All right, keep very still." And she feels where the hand is, and she goes like this, right as you come through the door.
Grimur! Are you here? Your father requests your presence.
Braggy!
She says, wow. She does it! Bam! Cuts her arm right off. We'll be with you in a second. We're cutting a woman's arm off.
Sorry, Braggy, we're busy.
So, blood starts coming out. She's like, "All right, hey, come here. I need your help."
Yes, of course.
She's screaming. "All right, we have to burn this now."
Oh.
we have to burn it so
okay.
that. Okay. So get the torch.
Okay.
Burn it.
Okay.
Put. She passes out. She passes out, and she's breathing heavily. But I rolled so well that she survives. And you guys cauterize it
nice.
With fire. And there's blood all over the floor in the hand. All right.
Inga, your skill is remarkable.
That was amazing.
Thank you. It took a long time to learn how to do that. There's stack of hands.
Arms.
Surely, I worked on my PhD of cutting off arms.
What is a PhD?
It's a special thing you get from a school that doesn't exist yet.
What is
this? All
right, so. Call them good deed doers.
What do you need?
The Jarl wishes to speak with Grimur.
About what?
There's a strange woman.
There's always a strange woman. Did he get a disease or something? Is he sick?
No, not this time.
Okay, go ahead.
No, a strange woman that Birna found wandering around our village.
Oh.
This is a very active day. Bears, strange women, excellent. All right, I'm gonna go,
Inga, I admire your optimism.
Well, we don't have much time.
Well, you don't.
Not that kind of.
You're damn, dude.
I'm not dead yet. Just go with him to the Jarl. I'll deal with the arm.
Lead on, Brock.
Let Leaf know on your way out that he accidentally cut off her arm. Her arm's gone.
Okay.
Just he needs to understand how important it is not to thrust without a sheath.
Okay.
Done. All right, so.
Beautiful.
Now.
So on
the. Use a sword.
All right.
It's the safest way to do it.
So you guys head out. You inform Leaf and you go. About?
Leaf, hey, she lost her arm, so.
Oh my God.
Next time, wrap it up.
Oh.
In a sheath.
I should have used a wooden sword. The fake ones work better and they're safer.
No, the safest.
Don't be
way
so
is...
down on yourself, Leaf. This shows you'll be a mighty warrior one day.
Oh.
That's not the message we're
not everyone can slice off a man or a woman's arm in one go. You should be proud.
I don't know what to say. It's terrible. I'm sure she'll be fine, but now she's...
Well, she doesn't have an arm.
That's the problem, though. She's not marriable anymore.
Jeez.
It's just too bad.
Well,
but
have a good day.
She'll live on forever in your proud deeds.
Yes, she will.
I'll make sure of it.
Maybe if she can still get into Valhalla if she fights.
Of course.
She won't have a shield, but she'll be fine. Maybe we could put it on her arm somehow.
Yeah,
I don't know. On her stump.
All that Valhalla requires is an honorable death in combat. And
true.
This has been made even easier now.
And she is almost 20. That's half a life. That's better than most.
Had a good long life.
Yeah.
Almost okay. 20.
So you leave. You guys leave and you go back. And now all four of you are finally in the same fucking place. <Yeah. laughs> So you guys get there.
I've got some Gaelic for you.
Oh, there's 2 hours.
Hang on,
late.
Here you go. So basically, my bad, thinking that flurf flurf was wrong.
Yeah,
not at all.
Totally right.
Totally right.
Now we know.
So I imagine like the only clothes I could find for her were mine, and they're way big on her.
Yeah.
Great.
You have giant clothes on.
Great.
And probably with fleas or something.
Of course.
You know.
Well.
I mean, you probably already had fleas.
You're all
though.
Basically dogs.
Yes.
So this fits with my predetermined ideas about the Norsemen.
Wow.
So
tie the clothes on so that they fit somewhat.
All right.
Have I gotten any food?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the first
Was
thing.
It edible?
Yes.
Well, it depends on what your view of that is.
Listen,
trust me, anything that's not Irish food is edible.
No, it is.
Let's
it's about
be honest.
What she thinks is edible.
You got some sun-ripened meat.
not goat, not goat, because you're very particular.
As per your request. Real monkey's paw going on there.
If I get some food and water and some decent clothes,
you're
am
feeling
I like
better.
Good to go?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you're feeling much better.
Yeah.
Every once in a while you'll get a flash of the boat and a horrible storm and getting attacked and maybe a birth, but nothing real solid. But so far, these people haven't attacked you. They've given you food, they've given you stuff, so they're not all bad.
Can you get more information from her? Like, how did she get here?
Where is she from?
She's from the Southland. She's a bride of the one god of the Weaklanders.
Oh, Anfroy talks about this god a lot. Yes. Is she from his home as well? Hold on. Parlez-vous? Français.
Oh.
No, I don't think so. She doesn't seem to understand my perfectly spoken French.
Are you familiar with the land of the Franks?
Yes, of course I know of the Franks. But I don't speak their language.
Just hearing a lot of mirth.
She doesn't speak the language.
Actually,
but she knows
now
the
she's
land
speaking.
Of
actually, wait a
old
second,
English,
though.
So it's. Right.
Actually, though, I speak Latin.
You
French is very close to Latin.
They all are, aren't they?
All the Romans.
They are. Can I figure out what he's saying?
Sure. Give me a roll against your Latin. That's hard.
Do you speak French?
I do not. Oh, I do not even slightly speak French.
Thank you.
Well, even the things that are Latin-like in what he is saying, I am misinterpreting so entirely.
They just confuse you more.
Bragi, I'm sure you are able to communicate with her.
What is your purpose in our lands?
I have no purpose in your lands. I was brought here against my will.
She seems upset.
By the monsters, the demons.
She keeps shouting about demons and monsters. What in our lands?
What sort of monsters?
Does it matter?
It might.
What monsters?
Monsters that look. They take the shape of a man. They take the shape of an evil, dirty, scummy Norseman. But they are not just evil, dirty, scummy Norsemen.
You shouldn't. You are a guest here.
Opens right up.
We don't treat you so nice.
You're doing very well, considering that you're dirty, horrible, stinking Norsemen.
Bragi has not struck her because he knows that the jar is interested in her, but. But I'm clear, like, when I'm raising this, that's what Bragi is doing. He's raising his hand like he's threatening to strike her.
Bragi, don't do anything.
Bragi, what is she saying?
She's insulting all our people. She's saying the monsters are Norsemen.
But no, they had a...
What is she doing?
Wait, though. What Norsemen did we have? We had no one out.
Hold on. What is she indicating?
Well, we're not the only village. There might be other people.
But which village is important?
What is she saying?
What is this? What are you saying?
They looked like they took the shape of a man, but the one had a mouth that opened on his neck.
A mouth that opened on the neck? I understood her now. It's like 13th Warrior. Okay.
Spend enough time listening.
Yes,
exactly.
She says they have gills like a fish.
Well, then obviously they're not Norsemen. She can't hate us. Tell her that.
Can I make a roll to see?
Those are no Norsemen. Norsemen have no gills on our neck.
If that's any
but
creature, would that be a cult?
Yeah, cults, yeah.
Okay.
All right now.
I made it.
30.
What's your cult like?
99.
Oh my God, how'd you get it?
Serious?
I didn't put points in a lot of other things.
That's why you play dead and hope not to die.
Yes.
Okay.
Wow, okay. I didn't think we were allowed to put any points in a cult, or I'd have dropped some points there.
Yeah, a cult's not supernatural, it's knowing about supernatural. 90, I didn't realize you could put up to a certain amount of points, but 99's a bit high.
Oh.
So, we'll talk about that.
I have an 89.
You made it no matter what. We'll talk about it later. You've heard stories about, like fish people, and I'm forgetting the name, and this is an Irish, the Sealy? Is it Sealy?
Selkies,
which are like sea lions or
they are typically described as people who can put on the seal or the skin of a seal.
They look like seals.
Become a seal.
You've heard about something about these things. Sometimes they'll invade villages and or corrupt villages, but that's all been like just myth. You've never heard of anybody actually. You've never heard anyone say I've met a creature like that. But they have human form, but they have gills and can swim really well and all that. So.
Nonsense. No Norseman has gills. We're not fish.
They dressed like Norsemen. They had a boat like Norsemen. They spoke like Norsemen. They invaded like Norsemen.
She
If it
says...
walks like a Norseman and quacks like a Norseman, it's a Norseman.
She says they look like Norsemen, but they had gills, but that they raided and that they had ships like ours, but I've not heard of anything like this.
What about what's Björk? What's Bikia. The, Bikia, have you heard of this before? Is this some kind of Loki thing that we have to now look out for, gill people?
No, I'm...
Speak up!
I'm trying. I'm sure, as Broggy knows, there are stories of creatures like this, but they're just stories. Nothing that has been seen by anyone who has lived to speak of it, at least.
All right, well. We don't have much more time until this invasion happens, and obviously we need to get ready for that.
We should probably lock her somewhere safe so that we can prepare for the battle.
No, that'll make things worse, I think. I don't think locking her up is going to...
But if she runs out into the battle and gets hurt, that's not good either, is it?
Can she fight? Can you fight?
She is quite. I mean, she has a spirit. Maybe I could teach her something.
No, thank you.
Can you fight?
How attached are you to your arm?
Very.
What's
very attached
on
to my arm.
What sheathed or unsheathed? What?
100% sheathed. 100%.
What does your god say about fighting?
My god says that you should defend yourself. But I'm not a fighter. I did not take any points
your
in any of those things.
Your god has taken you as a bride and not taught you how to defend yourself? He says that you should, but says you should not?
I defend myself through prayer. I pray, I seek visions, and through those I defend myself. But I'm pretty good at medicine. Just saying. I put some points into that.
She speaks strangely.
No.
Blah, 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 blah.
Wait a second. No. I have some points in persuade. I would like to attempt to persuade him that you need to take me along.
Take you along to where?
In the battle?
I don't know that I want to go into battle.
I haven't told her there's a battle yet.
That's true.
I just asked if she can fight.
Right. Okay, tell me some more stuff so I can decide what to persuade you of.
Well, I need to go and look at whether or not we're prepared. I want you to make sure she's safe is Bjorn ready? Bjork, I mean. It's Bjork, right? She has that shield with the...
Swan.
Swan, yes.
She's nice.
Ready. She helped you guys, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, good.
Yes.
And then who's the
you
one that
be here otherwise?
Blood. Out of his eyes for some reason. And then the one that you're always fighting with, where is she?
Groa.
Yeah, where's Groa? She's a good warrior, correct?
She's a bit indisposed at the moment.
What do you mean? What's wrong?
She lost an arm.
How'd she lose an arm?
It was a thrusting without a sheath incident.
Damn it.
She was training and didn't block properly.
She didn't block? You weren't involved, were you, correct?
I was helping with the training, but I did not
cause
that.
How are you helping with the training?
I was helping to teach Leaf. You know, he wants to learn.
So Leaf was thrusting and you were helping out.
I was.
And you cut his arm.
He's got to get a good thrust.
And you cut her arm.
I did.
You
no,
cost
Leaf
us. Did you, really? Who shoved his arm forward in a thrusting motion with the sword in it?
Leaf and I did it together.
Odin, what have you done? Okay. All right, so we're down.
Well, she can still fight.
Can she still?
Any good
did she
warrior
lose her
can.
Arm?
Yes, Inga and I had to remove her arm.
That's too bad. All right, well.
I'm helping Inga.
Jarl, the Outlander says that she's no fighter, but that she knows the ways of herbs and medicine.
Well, that might help. That might help. Give her a sword anyway, but, you know, or a dagger or something. When the battle starts.
It shall be done.
Okay. I'm going to go look around and see who else you've stabbed. All right.
I only stab the enemy or anybody who picks a fight with me. You know that.
Yes.
With the slightest provocation. You know that.
At the drop of a hat, I kill the motherfuckers.
You starting shit?
Thrust.
Indiscriminate thrusting.
I'm just gonna walk forward thrusting if you're in the way.
Inga started it.
It was Inga's fault. Okay, so he leaves, and it's the four of you in there. At this point, a good chunk of the day has gone by.
Yeah, it sounds like it.
You guys have been kind of doing all of this thing. You're hoping no one's found your bear carcass. Maybe you threw it in your house before. You just kind of chucked it in.
Yeah.
Okay.
Into the ripening room.
Yeah.
Into the ripening room.
The offal out into the woods so the bears stop coming into my house.
And so it's late at night. It's getting late, and it's you guys know that you're going to have to be up in a few hours to start hopefully defending yourself if the prophecy is true, which you're pretty confident it is. So, the Jarl comes back after a while and says, have you guys seen Mangus at all since you got back? I haven't seen him. And I can't, he's not answering his door. Can you guys go search for him for me?
Of course.
Okay. Take her with you because I don't want her to think that she's in any danger with
you. Come with me.
I instantly feel like I'm in danger.
Yes.
Come along. The Jarl has decided to extend his protection to you. We are facing a battle tonight, but your skills might be useful.
Your healing skills.
Right. I see.
Here.
But now we must find Magnus.
Magnus did consume two hearts. Perhaps he has struck out in the woods in one of his bouts of heart madness.
He does that.
Would it be heartburn?
Sorry. No.
Oh, but that was certainly a heart attack.
Oh. Need your heart.
Yeah. Perhaps he's home because home is where the heart is.
Should I carry her again?
No.
Is she going to come?
No, I'm going to persuade her not to carry me. I don't. I failed to do that.
Her legs are weak and unsteady. You may wish to carry her.
Of course.
Huck her right over your shoulder. You're like a shawl.
And I'm not.
All right. So you guys go to Mangus's house. And you hear this, you can hear him inside kind of breathing heavy. He goes, who's there?
It's Birna.
And Grimir.
Oh, good. It's Jarl's not with you, right?
Previously, I introduced Raggi, your old friend.
He knows who you are.
I know.
Bosom buddies.
It's Jarl's not with you, right?
Mr. Poopy Bottom.
Who?
The Jarl.
No.
He's not with you.
No.
But all right. We do have this, I don't know, woman from somewhere else.
I can't fight. I haven't stomach issues.
Oh.
I ate too much.
Too many hearts.
Too many hearts. It's bad.
Oh, God. Is it truly the heart's friend?
Shut up, you idiot. But that was funny. Yes. Just be quiet. I'm trying really hard not to puke. Well, you can't let the Jarl know that I can't fight.
What should we tell him?
Look, I'll make an appearance. I'll go out during the battle towards the end and kill someone just randomly. But don't let the Jarl know I'm sick, okay? I don't want anyone to know.
But Magnus, this time try and let it be one of the invaders that you kill at random.
That was that one time. I didn't know.
We have a healer with us. Perhaps if she looked at you,
she
may be able to make, her ways are strange and her tongue is stranger, but she may be able to put you better.
Raggi, sometimes for narrative reasons, Magnus decides that he cannot fight.
Right, gotcha.
Yes. He does this sometimes.
Yeah.
For narrative purposes.
Right. Would narratively enjoy the ride in the Fiat. Psychology help on him?
Do you have psychology?
I do. In fact, I have psychology.
Psychology? I don't know.
You could try it.
Because I'm a scholar. Yeah, part that makes of our sense. Thing is talking and...
Sure, give him a psychology roll. Let's see where this goes.
Whoops.
Lamo?
No!
82!
Get the hell out of my place!
I think he's attracted to his mother. I read a book once about psychology.
Oh, yeah. Don't tell me that. That's terrible. It's my grandmother.
He said something about a cigar. I don't know.
Oh, look, just go. I'll be fine. I just... Bear hearts take a long time to get up. I'm just saying. It's going to be a little while. You know, I'll get there. Just
all right, Magnus. Take care.
It'll be fine. Okay. All right.
I'm very concerned about my well-being since we're basically going around visiting all of your hurt people.
All right. Are you happy that so many people are hurt and weak?
Here's
and that
the thing.
God will be able to wreak his vengeance upon them?
That's always a plus.
I thought you'd be saying it my way.
But if I sit and think hard about this, I don't know how I got off the boat with the monsters, but I managed to get to shore somehow, so I couldn't have been in the middle of the ocean, which means they might be nearby.
That's what I'm worried about.
I mean, I was fixed up with... crappy meal and a glass of water. I wasn't that bad off.
Are you saying any of this out loud? Or is this all internal monologue?
Hard-boiled PI internal monologue.
First it's internal.
Bum, bum, bum.
And then to you I say, the monsters might be near. I don't know where they are. And why would they have dropped me here? Maybe they're coming to get you next.
Ding, you hear...
Dang it, that's probably them!
You hear swords hitting, fisherman. And suddenly, help! I need more people now!
I will...
What's happening?
Come on!
Drop you and run off to whatever is happening.
Would you drop? I think you might just
come along,
run.
Come along.
I guess I might. I don't probably know she's there, I guess.
I don't know if you would. It's up to you. It's your choice.
You're basically wearing a nun necklace.
sure. I'll just head to the direction of what's happening.
I'm a Christian now. I have a rosary. Yeah. It's a nun.
It's just a nun.
It's just a nun.
That's back in the day, that's how you showed true devotion, was you wore a nun.
Anyone wore a nun.
Yeah. It's a new definition of prayer.
It did, after a while, it became a bad habit.
Oh!
All right.
Bam.
Scene.
So you run. You're hearing all this battle. You would probably run as well. Are you going towards the battle?
I mean, I'll lope.
You'll lope towards the battle.
Okay.
All right. And you guys get down to near where she was, towards the water. Now it's nighttime, and as you get down there, you see. Five people, five Vikings you've never seen before, and they've got what's his name again? Rex Skepson, okay, is fighting with them, and he's surrounded completely.
Who is
right?
that?
Rex Skepson is the name.
Rex?
This is not someone we've met before.
No.
Okay.
This is a new
person. But it's someone we know.
This is someone that from the village, yeah.
What does he do?
He's a younger guy. He's kind of like you guys. He's a younger guy that does woodworking with his father, who's a carpenter, and also is learning how to fight, and he's surrounded by these five people.
Is there any insignia or anything about the attacking warriors that I might recognize as another village or a specific enemy?
They look like, two of them look, you recognize two of them from the ones that you fought in the woods. So they're the Sigurd's people, the albinos people, and they probably are scouting and found him, Rixkun. So.
Do I recognize him?
Make an idea roll. Or, yeah, make an intelligence roll.
An intelligence roll?
Yeah, just against your intelligence.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you look around and one of them's very familiar looking to you.
Okay.
So these guys are attacking him, and unless you guys do something real fast.
I'm going to set her down and draw my sword and go after them.
Okay. So Reekscap is fighting, and they're laying it on. They've got axes, everything. So real quick, I'm just going to go around. I know you're not fighting, but what is your dex?
60. I'm sorry, no, my dex, 35.
Wow.
Really bad.
Yeah. Okay. What is your dex?
65.
Okay. What is your dex?
35.
Jeez. What is your dex?
80.
Wow, okay.
Crappy dex.
Dex.
Wow, so we're you're first. Brothers.
All right.
You're first. What do you want to do?
Stay here, and if they approach, use this. And I throw a dagger at your feet. And I will run down to defend our comrade.
Okay. Okay. So they are, I guess, super slow. All right. So go ahead and do what you're going to do.
Okay.
You run into the middle of these guys. How are you attacking?
Is there a clear shot with a spear? Like if I throw my spear at one of them?
If you want to huck a spear, that's fine.
Okay.
Go for it. Don't critically fail.
Well, let me pause then, because and dispel the curse.
Yeah. Don't do it.
26.
I didn't curse you.
Yeah. No, you didn't. 26.
Nice.
Makes it by.
All right.
20 points or so.
So that's a success. And then there. Let's see. 44. Okay. That's a failure on dodge, so that means that you got a better success, so you hit, do your damage. Oh!
That's gonna be 8 points.
Okay, yeah. That's a major wound for him. So he stumbles back, he's got a spear in him, and the other four realize...
That's my lucky spear! I killed a bear with that today!
Good one, Braggy!
Flurgen. Okay, so.
Oh, this means
weird. This guy's
so,
weird.
You hit one of them.
And then I'll run down, you know, to the rest.
Okay, so that brings us to you.
I want Brianna. To run to the whatever the closest one is and attack
okay.
with my sword.
Are you throw her down, right, or do you
yeah.
keep her on
no,
your shoulder?
I set her
I got down. A. Yeah. Ow! He gave me a dagger.
Yes, he did.
I have it.
Okay.
Just letting everyone know.
Yeah.
Did he hit the one that I recognize, kinda?
No, he did not.
I'm keeping an eye on that one.
All right.
I'll just attack whatever the closest one is.
All right. Go ahead.
That is a 47 under my 75.
All right. So, let's see. So that's... Is that a hard success for you? Is it
no.
half your... So it's just a regular success. Okay.
Yeah. It's 10 over my...
Okay, that's a 9. He definitely dodges. Your glory can come into effect now, if you'd
okay.
like.
Sure.
All right. So he dodges and looks at you and goes, oh, my God, kind of freaks out a little bit. Mm-hmm. I've heard of you before.
Then you know
you Brenna.
Probably should not be here.
He kind of tries to straighten up. And you, like, loom over him.
How can he be sure it's you? I mean, there's got to be a lot of 7 feet, 300-pound Viking 17-year-olds.
Who are you?
With two arms.
Who, with two arms? Who sent you here, and why are you here now?
We're here, our forces are coming, and We're gonna take over this town. Shut up, man. Be quiet. You're telling her everything.
How many are left? How many?
He didn't kill. He just right. He had. So there's five of them.
But one is
majorly wounded.
Yes, seriously, major wound. So do you want to try to hit him? Or wait, did you?
I really want to be able to take this one back to the Jarl, but we got to take care of the other ones first.
Okay, yes. All right, so that brings us to the other two, and then you go, which I'm pretty sure you're going to play dead, right?
No.
Okay.
He's gonna.
These are not bears. No. That is not a good strategy. Right.
He's going to commune with a god.
Two towns over. Okay, so you guys, you're on your way down. You're there, so they're both gonna swing at you. All right, so that's a 38. Do you want to use your shield or do you want to try to dodge?
I'll probably use my shield.
Okay, so it's just your dodge. It's
where
the same.
Where is my dodge? I have my shield is higher.
Okay, use your shield then.
I must have put points.
You
in
put
it.
Points in it. Okay.
Oof. No, my shield's 52. That's a 71.
You could push it.
You want to push it?
Push it real good.
The table's got four pushes.
Push it.
Four table push.
Yes, 47 under my 52.
All right, so it hits your shield. Your shield takes 2 points of damage.
Oogie.
You actually have a, I thought you had a new shield because you picked up a shield.
It's probably a new shield.
You picked up a shield from the dudes that we killed.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, I figured you had a new shield. Usually get new ones. All right, so it bounces off. The second guy attacks you. Oh, misses you completely.
Yep.
Can I have that? Thank you.
You can have nothing.
All right, so that brings us to 35s. That's the two of you.
So I kind of smile at her reassuringly and move into a defensive stance in front of her.
All right. In a weird
with my back to you.
In a weird kind of loping way.
Okay.
Nice.
That's fancy and all.
Have you ever seen the Dark Crystal?
Yes,
when they walk around?
Oh dear.
It's kind of what he's doing. It's a lope.
The Skeksis?
Yeah.
That's weird.
No, that's not what I do. That is not accurate.
It's not?
No. More like I don't know, I'll think of another Muppety type thing that describes it.
Okay. Something from the Labyrinth.
So I picked up this dagger that he left for me.
Alright.
My eyes do not leave the one that looks familiar to me.
Alright.
And I think to myself, not at all do I want to get involved in this fight. But that the people I'm with, I'm fighting the bad demon guy, reassures me. But I think to myself, they have to have gotten here on a boat. And I'm going to find it, and I'm going to sink it.
Okay.
So I'm going to go around them.
All right.
And find their boat.
Okay.
And sink it.
So.
Sink that boat.
Give me, do you have stealth at all, or?
I do.
New.
Where are we going? Yes.
Navy SEALs.
Sink that boat.
All right, so you start going around. It starts to rain.
Of course it does.
Does she go around in, front of me?
Yeah, you see her go like this, like on the side, like going into the woods a little bit off the thing.
Mare.
Kind of go around.
Mare. Norgan.
Muff, muff.
I'm gonna follow after her.
Okay. Lopingly long you go.
I'm gonna lope after her.
Okay. Rain's totally cold. Make it. Super right. Stealthy.
Give me, do you have stealth?
That was a 23
it is
and my stealth
on my sheet.
Roll look against
at,
it.
Look at that, you got 20.
I mean, I'm not trying to sneak though. I'm just trying to follow her, yeah.
So
wait,
you're
is
like,
he gonna give my
you
position
sneak away?
Away?
And then like, he's just like walking behind you.
Jerk.
I mean, well, I'm chasing after her.
Like, okay,
I don't know what she's doing, but I'm trying to keep her safe.
Okay. So yeah, he's shadowing you.
Okay. So it didn't even matter that I was stealthy?
Not really.
Well,
because they're all
black bag.
They're in a fight.
Black bag.
My last character had stealth, but I was the only one at the table that did.
Yes.
Gotcha.
Let's sneak. Okay, never mind.
Okay, we're sneaking.
That's a bad idea.
Sneak, so, sneak, sneak.
Sneak, sneak, sneak. Sneak, sneak, sneak.
All right.
So you guys are in the woods, right?
Uh-huh. Are we gonna get attacked by a bear?
You've got...
Is it from chat sent us a bear?
You've got your dagger out.
Don't send us a bear! Send us a bear!
Hold on, I'm gonna log in.
Watch you!
Don't worry, I know what to do with bears.
Throw a spear at them!
All right. So you guys go in, and as you're going around, you see the boat.
Okay.
Just down the shore a little bit.
Uh-huh. I'm continuing with my plan. I just think you're going to make it blow up in my face, which I respect. I respect that.
Are you going to stick your dagger
I'm trying to go after her to like try and get her to stop.
Yeah, you see this boat that you've never seen. The markings are a bit weird.
You can't just poke dagger at it.
Okay, so nothing I recognize?
No.
Okay.
You go up towards the boat?
Yeah.